Honourable Minister for Health, you have the floor.
Thank you, Honourable Speaker. I rise briefly to contribute to the debate on the report before the House. The Honourable Prime Minister, Honourable Cabinet Ministers, Honourable Acting Leader of the Opposition. I must say that we are all immensely proud of this university. It's our national university, and more importantly, it's a university that argues well with the development of our nation through the needs of our nation. And one thing that I've been pleasantly happy with as being an academic myself in this university is the industrial committee meetings within the university, in which we sit down and listen to the industry and what the industry needs are. And then we work within the university. When I used to be with the university, we then work with the industry to ensure that we offer programs that meet the industry needs. And this, I think, has been very important, specifically around health, meeting some of the needs that we have specifically for specialized skill areas. For example, a certification in particular areas that may not be available in other forms of training. For example, we had needed at one time to have phlebotomists to be able to take blood out without doctors actually going to take blood out for themselves. So the Fiji National University came to the fore and made sure that they provided the program for us, and many other small programs that they provide, which is actually very important for the development of our nation. Within health, I was very also immensely happy at the end of last year to participate in the opening of the WHO Collaborating Center at the College of Medicine, Nursing and Health Science with the FNU. This means that FNU is one of the few, or maybe the only university in the Pacific outside of Australia and New Zealand, that has a WHO Collaborating Center specifically for the prevention of obesity and NCD. And this argues well in the health aspect, because it shows that the FNU has the ability and has been able to do research over the years pertaining leading up to the designation as a WHO Collaborating Center. And this is not an easy feat. For a university to be able to achieve this, or an institution to achieve this, they have to ensure, they have to show that they have quality publications that they've done over many years. They've published it in reputable journals, and this has been recognized by WHO. WHO then gives the designation as a WHO Collaborating Center. So this is something that I believe that shows the capacity and the capability that our university has. One thing that is also certain, Honorable Speaker, is that universities need at least 30, 40, 50 years to mature. That is something that any academic will tell you. It doesn't happen overnight. If we look at the most impressive universities around the world, like Oxford, they've been around for centuries. St. Andrews in Scotland. If you look at Harvard, it was one of the first universities to be developed in the United States. They need time. And that time develops the intellectual capacity. But in that time, we need to continue with the investment. The investment is not only in terms of the resources, in terms of money, but also investment in making sure that we have the right people at the right place. And the university has gone through many reforms within its HR sector to ensure that it picks the right people at the right place to be able to contribute to the growth of our nation through the academia. So, Honorable Speaker, I stand today just to contribute to this motion before the House, and I support the report as it is. Thank you, Honorable Speaker.